Hello dear students, today we are going to start a new chapter from science, that is force and pressure. So students, in our daily routine we are performing different tasks, we are carried out different kind of work, and to do all of works we have to apply force, we have to exert force. And in this chapter we are going to learn important physical quantities, these are force and pressure. So let us start this session with first point, at first quantity, it is force. Now students, let us know what is force through some examples. Before this, simply force can be defined as pushing, pulling and lifting of object is nothing but a force. Pushing, pulling and lifting, and lifting of object is nothing but a force. So some examples are given in your textbook. We will see this through that examples. So first examples in that, a man pushing a car. A man pushing a car. And second example, it is a boy pulling a dog. Pulling a dog. So see these two examples. In that, man exerting force on a car. And in second example, boy exerting or applying force on a dog. And man is pushing a car, where dog is boy is pulling a dog. Means they are exerting force. So force is pushing and force is pulling the object. Now students, suppose this is a duster on any surface. If I want to take it, what I want to do? I want to lift this duster. I want to lift this object. Means I am lifting duster, I am exerting force on this duster. Again, force is lifting of object. So, this is about force. Now, in last standard we have studied about Newton's first law of motion. Let us study that law here again. Suppose this is a ball and this is ball at position A and this is another ball at position B. Just suppose that ball A is steady, it is in the rest, and another ball, that B, it is in the motion. Suppose that ball B is in the motion. Now, in case of ball A, it will remain steady or it will remains in the rest till we are not acting force on this ball. If we just push the ball, then that ball gets speed. Okay? It will be there in the speed. If we push the ball, then it starts moving. And in case of ball B, which is in the motion, that ball is already in the motion. And it will remain in the motion till we are not acting any kind of force on it. If we are applying force on it, either it goes fast or it goes slow or it stops. So, Newton's first law of motion, it states that object will be there in the motion or will be there in the rest till another force is not acting on it. That we have studied in last standard and it is very important. Now students, this force is properly defined as a physical quantity that changes shape, speed and direction of any object. So what changes force? Force can change the shape of object, speed of object and direction of object. Now, these three things are changes by the force. So, these are also called as the effects of force. These are also called effects of force. Remember this very carefully. It will ask what are the effects of force. Now, students, let us see these three things with some examples. Students, shape. In the process of making dough, every day we are making dough at our home. Okay students, so suppose this is dough and we are applying pressure by our hand. We are applying force on this, and in this way, due to force, due to muscular force of our hands, that dough is changes their shape. So force changes the shape of object. Now speed. Before some time we have seen the example of ball B was there in the motion. Ball B was there in the motion. If we apply force on it, then either a ball that goes fast or it will go slow. In this way, or sometimes it will stop too. So speed is changes by applying force, by exerting force on object. Means if we apply force on it, it goes fast or goes slow. Now direction, how the direction is changes. Suppose we are driving a car and we are applying force on steering. At that time, the speedy car, the car which was there in the motion, that changes their direction. So in this way, by applying force, shape, speed and direction of any object is changes. So properly, force is defined as a physical quantity which changes direction, speed and shape of object. And force is denoted by capital F and the SI unit of force, it is Newton. Newton. Okay students, remember these things very carefully. Now come to the next point, that is types of forces. Next point will be types. So first type, before this some types of forces, basic types of forces we have studied in standard, I think in a 6th standard, that is muscular force, mechanical force, frictional force was there, and gravitational force and magnetic force. So we have studied all that types of forces into standard 6. Now students, now our next point is contact forces and non-contact forces. See very carefully, contact forces and non-contact forces, non-contact. So students, what are contact forces and non-contact forces? First, contact force. Where the force is applied, then two objects are there in the contact. Then it is said to be the type of contact force. And objects are not there in the contact while the force is acting. The types we have studied, these are muscular force, mechanical force, and frictional force. They are coming into the contact force. And next to that is gravitational force, and magnetic force. They are coming under non-contact force. Let us see how. We have seen example of making dough, process of making dough. In that, what happened? Our hands and that object, our hands, means we are applying force with our hands, muscular force with our hands on dough. So here, dough and our hand, these two objects are there in the contact. So muscular force is a type of contact force. Now next, mechanical force. Well-known example, typical example of mechanical force is opening and closing of door. So to open and close the door, our hand and that door, these two objects are there in the contact. So again, it is a type of contact force. And frictional force, very well-known example, while we are riding a bicycle, when immediately we apply brakes, then what happens? That wheel or our bike gets stopped due to friction, which is carried out between these two things, wheel and road. Means while the frictional force is applying, at that time wheel and road, these two objects are there in the contact, so that it comes. Frictional force is a type of contact force. So these are example of contact force, which is nothing but two objects are there in the contact while force is acting. Okay, so come to the next, non-contact force. Gravitational force, it is a very important type of force. We know Earth is having gravitational force, and due to that force, every object is attracted towards the Earth. Suppose this is an Earth and this is any tree. Suppose coconut tree on the Earth. So these coconuts, these are falling after ripening, they are falling down towards the earth surface. Till these two things are not in the contact, coconut and earth surface, these two objects are not in a contact, Still after that force, gravitational force is acting on that coconut, means here two objects are not there in the contact. So gravitational force is type of non-contact force. Now let us see another type, that is magnetic force. Magnetic force. So we know that magnet is having tendency to attract every iron object towards, magnetic material toward itself. Suppose this is magnet and these are some magnetic material. Okay, so magnetic material and that magnet, they are not in the contact till that magnet attracts these towards their pole and they are stick here. So students, here magnetic force is applied till the objects are not there in the contact. So it is again a type of non-contact force, which is defined as when two objects are not there in the contact while force is acting. So in this way, this is the first type of force, that is contact forces and non-contact forces. All these types are comes muscular, mechanical and frictional force. They are come under the contact forces, where gravitational and magnetic forces, they are come under non-contact forces. Remember all the examples that we have studied here. So let us wind up the session. In next video, we will learn about balanced and unbalanced forces. Till then, thank you.